A pleasant and blessed day to each and everyone here in this platform, participating in this call and responding to the higher calling of research. I am Joana Rose M. Espiritu, a public secondary school English teacher from Guevara High School, Guevara, La Paz, Tarlac, here in the Philippines. And I believe that the ultimate legacy of leadership is lifelong learning, and academic institutions aspire and perspire for lifelong education. The academe, in whatever level it may be, it exists to house academicians. Moreover, the academe does not pertain merely or exclusively to colleges and universities. We in the basic education should be no different and no less than the tertiary education institutions when it comes to what we do with and how we actually dig knowledge and information. And it is with deep conviction that I assert that we should have functions greater than its dissemination and merely imparting them to our learners. We may similarly perform active roles in manufacturing and generating it through self-willed and self-propelled investigation and research. And from this basic belief and disposition, or we may also call it aspiration, that a few months and a year ago, I proposed and conducted this study, which is aptly titled as Research Characteristics and Challenges of DepEd Towards a Proposed Program. My paper was able to explore the 7 provinces of Region 3. Now, for my study particularly, only included were the mega national high schools with SBM Level 3 status of practice, which account for 61 public secondary schools in the entire region. Included only were the teachers who are currently positioned as Teacher 3 and higher. So through Cochrane's formula, the total reasonable sample of 53 school heads and 385 secondary school teachers assuming Teacher 3 and higher post were arrived at. Now for the statement of the problem of my study, how was the Department of Education Region 3's research described in terms of the following? Institutional characteristics, individual characteristics, leadership characteristics. Now, for this purpose, a modified checklist questionnaire composed of 84 items was crafted, conceptually based on the instruments of 2 groups of scholars, namely Iqbal, Halal, and Mahmud in 2018 and Adikunle and Madukoma in 2022. Now, from the summary of responses for each dimension of characteristics indicative of research culture development, it can be concluded that the evident existence of institutional, individual, and leadership characteristics give enough proofs to what we will assert and claim that, therefore, the growing and developing culture of research in DepEd Region 3 was confirmed to be evident and existent. Now for my second inquiry, what are the challenges encountered by the school heads in facilitating research? Now for this purpose, a 15-item self-structured checklist was designed, deriving conceptual underpinnings from the study of Marchand in 2009, specifically her classifications of obstacles to staff research. Now from the findings, it could be gleaned that almost all of the participants had confirmed that all of the challenges included in the second research instrument had accurately captured the hindrances which had made facilitating research in the respective areas of assignment as problematic or difficult. To name a few, we have the top 10 challenges flashed on the screen. Now, though the general responses of participants point to the evident existence of the visible 3-dimensional indicators of research culture development, still, it does not exempt the school heads from experiencing and encountering hurdles or impediments to set the pace of the growth and development of research culture development quicker or faster. Now, these challenges experienced by school heads in facilitating research in their respective institutions may be generally attributed to the unifocal function orientation of local school administrators as well as public school teachers, which directs them to be totally consumed by their fundamental job description, that is, supervision and instruction, which may not be apparently comparable
to the trifocal function of educators in higher education institutions, inclusive of instruction, research, and extension. The culture which mirrors and determines the institution's concentrations, thrust, and priorities is still predominantly retained by pedagogy. So from the visuals and illustrative representations, we see school heads as the chief and key personnel who are looked upon to put forward research and bank on or take advantage of the evidently existing characteristics, correspondingly confirming the existence of research culture in their respective institutions. Now, in the face of challenges, they are similarly expected to be resourceful and wise enough to brave and surmount all of these struggles. Now, in doing so, however, they became deeply soaked, drenched so deep, and they may drown and metaphorically meet their doom by virtue of suffocation in the process. Which leads us now to our third statement of the problem. What research program could be proposed to address these challenges? And so for this purpose, we rightfully propose the program rightfully named and labeled as Program Localized Rescued. By rescued, we mean research empowerment in schools through collaboration towards utility, excellence, and dissemination. Now, the proposed program seeks to assist DepEd Region 3 in advancing to higher stages of research culture development, transitioning from its current status of gestation towards maturation through its grassroots approach of addressing challenges encountered in facilitating research and its commitment and investment on the empowerment of schools, which may result to greater evidences and manifestations of the institutional, individual, and leadership characteristics conducive for the development of research culture in secondary schools of Department of Education, Region 3. In terms of research empowerment, we convene key personnel who will compose the School Research Committee or the SRCOM, which will be chief implementers of this program. In attaining or in securing collaboration, we scout and groom research experts and mentors among the prospective researchers in each secondary school in the region. In achieving utility, we launch regular research colloquiums as venues of localized research presentations, and in securing excellence and dissemination, we produce a digital and print publication compiling locally conducted researches. For our last statement of the problem, we have, what are the implications of the proposed research program to educational management? Now, abundant confirmations from the participants may have presented adequate proofs to conclude that the research culture development in mega national high schools with SBM Level 3 status of practice in DepEd Region 3 is already existent and in constant motion. Still, the challenges which the school heads had similarly almost unanimously attested to have hampered the research facilitation endeavors, somewhat debunk this uniform claim and invite probes about its exact pace of movement. Now, since all of our efforts in the basic education uniformly showcase the matatag mantra and thrust of the Department of Education, now towards that direction, a matatag research culture will certainly be in harmony and hopefully become the key leadership strategy upon which impactful programs and policies may be crafted and implemented. Now, from these crucial findings and conclusions, a few of my paper's recommendations were worth mentioning and be considered for courses of actions and future directions. Now, administrators and higher authorities in DepEd Region 3, particularly the concerned chief education program supervisors from these concerned units, should craft opportunities and avenues to further equip and showcase skills and potentials of prospective teacher researchers in the field through issuances detailing budgetary allocations and capacity building matrices of research trainings and right shops. And with that, I conclude my presentation of my paper's salient findings, conclusions, and recommendations. Again, I am Joana Rose, M. Espiritu. Thank you so much for listening.